plan to make everything greener, but I need to be keener on where to plant and what to grow. I'm a little bit low on my knowledge.
Elsa Rae and her tiny instruments are back on the music scene after a three-year hiatus. The singer took some time away from the stage for parenthood, but she's back this month with the performance at Headlights Theater. Now, Headlights Theater, in case you didn't know, was started during the pandemic in Sioux Falls. It's a place where people can go to enjoy socially distanced entertainment, and it has found its niche in the Sioux Falls community. Elsa Rae plays July 22nd, and she has brought her instrument, not a tiny one, but the regular guitar, into our SDPB Sioux Falls studio. Welcome. Thanks for being here.
Thanks, Lori.
Tell us a little bit about that break, because a lot of musicians have come here and have had to take a break for pandemic. You also have a break for family. And what does that mean for you as a musician?
Yeah, after probably 5 or 6 years of constant songwriting, experimenting, performing, traveling, I found myself back in Sioux Falls with the intention of recording, performing, also moving on.
Yeah.
And then at this stage in my life, when I ended up coming back home, I saw my roots again for the first time in a while. And I wanted to embrace them. Mm. And then around the same time, I also fell madly in love with a school teacher.
Yeah.
And then that put me in the position of really considering the lifestyle of a musician and then the lifestyle of a devoted partner in starting a family.
Yeah.
And it was very obvious to me which one I wanted to go down. So I very readily just put music on the shelf, and I funneled all of my passion and creative energy into literally creating children with my now husband. And we've got a 4-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 1-year-old.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And so 4 kids in 3.5 years. But after my youngest reached this point, I just noticed that the desire to play was there. It was very deep, kind of buried almost, but I felt it. And so I kind of found the music that had collected dust on the shelf, and I took it down, and I've been trying to, you know, just refine my creative expression.
Yeah,
again.
It's time.
It's time.
Yeah. It's just being a human being.
Yeah.
And going through different journeys and stages and then saying, music is still this identity.
Yeah.
It's not one of my favorite, people ask what your favorite word is, and I always say and.
Hmm.
It's not or. Sometimes it's just and. You can be the great parent and a great musician.
Yeah.
Yeah. What will you play for us today here in the studio?
The first song I'm going to play is one I wrote when I was 19 on the ukulele, but I'm going to play it on guitar, and it's called Catfish Song. Oh, you saw dream last night. I was sailing alone in a ship of white. I asked you to come aboard my little boat of hopes and dreams. You blinked your eyes 3 times and sat in silent reverie. Darling, please do not wake me. I'm sleeping these days away. So please do not wake me. I've got no intent of seeing you today.
I jumped into the sea of blue. I drowned slowly among the sharks and the catfish too. You woke then, my dear, to find me laying at your side. Yet part of you wished that I had really died. Then you said, then you said, oh darling, please do not wake me. I am sleeping, I'm sleeping, I'm sleeping these days away, so please do not wake me. I've got no intent of seeing you today. I've got no intent of seeing you today.
Elsa Rae live in SDPB's Sioux Falls studio. She's playing for the Headlight Theater performance on July 22nd. Oh, that. Thank you. Yeah. On behalf of everyone who's going to email me later and say thank you, I'm going to tell you pre now that that is exactly what they needed this Monday, because that's what they're going to tell me.
Yeah.
We'll close the show with the recorded Flower Man so people can hear live and recorded.
Great.
And put information up on how to find your music. Go to Bandcamp, Elsa Rae, R-A-E, is
yes.
Rae. And, but the writing of that is just so extraordinary, beside the performance being miraculous. As a 19-year-old, you're writing that.
Yeah, and what I realize now, because I wrote that after I got my heart broken for the first time. So it was like very raw. But I really feel like I wrote songs that were way more mature than I was at the time.
Yeah.
And I connect more to the songs that I wrote as a late teen, early 20s person. I connect more to them now.
Right.
Because I have an even deeper understanding. And I think that after a hiatus and just also growing up and getting older, I think I'm actually better at playing these songs now than I was then.
You were writing for future you.
I was writing for future me.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Who are you writing for now?
My kids.
Yeah.
Probably.
Future them.
Future them.
We will leave you with Flower Man from Elsa Rae so you can hear the recording. Again, we'll put that information up on our website at sdpb.org/news. And so Headlights Theater, by the way, is an undisclosed location in downtown Sioux Falls on January 22nd. So here's the game. You have to wait for 8 p.m. to be notified about where you're going. It's donation-based, so people give what they can to keep the performances going. Elsa Rae, thank you so much.
Thanks, Lori.
And thank you for listening.
Flower man, thanks to your plans, ever.